那么，随着现在 LGBTQ 这样的活动越来越猖狂吧，有更多的另外一群人走进了我们的视野。那这一群人呢，就是 detransitioner。那他们在整个这个变性还有变回来这个过程中呢，经历了无限的痛苦，在经历了严重的心理疾病、求助无门的过程中，他们就被人引导向改变性别、改变性向，甚至走上切除性别器官这样一个道路上。到最后导致他们伤痕累累，他们的身体受到了无法逆转的创伤。那在这里呢，就跟大家来讲一下，有一个女生，她叫做 Camille，今年32岁，她呢就是这些 detransitioner 的其中的一位。那她在她年幼的时候经历过很严重的心理创伤，那在这之后呢，她就产生了严重的心理疾病，这导致她对于自己身体的女性器官感觉到非常的不舒服。于是呢，从2016年的时候，他就开始去见这个治疗师啊。他被诊断为非二进制，非二进制是什么意思？就是这个治疗师告诉他说，你啊，这有问题哈，就出在你的性别上面。其实呢，你不是男人，也不是女人。那通过看病看了几年下来，这个情况没有好转，反而是越来越严重。那一直到了2020年呢，他就感觉到说，哎，或许呢。我如果要是切除胸部哈，可能就会减缓我这个疾病，甚至是可以消除精神和情感上的痛苦。那于是呢，在2020年的5月份，他求助找到了一名社工。那这个社工呢，跟他进行了1个小时的 Zoom meeting 的会议。在那之后，他又在7月份与这个变性的医生进行了40分钟的视频通话。啊，那在这两个会议开完了之后呢，这两位专家就都写了一封推荐信，这个推荐信上面写的是建议这个女生要做胸部切除的手术。那么在医生下了诊断之后呢，她就接受了医生的建议，哈，这个女生就接受了切除胸部的手术。但是让她意想不到的是，在手术过后，不仅仅她的心理问题没有得到任何的解决，她的身体还造成了一系列的后遗症。无缘无故来的疼痛、失眠、耳鸣等等各种让身心都备受折磨的症状困扰着他。
I was struggling with severe mental illness, CPTSD, major depressive disorder, ADHD, generalized anxiety disorder, and suicidal ideation. Knowing this, my doctors approved and performed a gender-neutral top surgery on me, one between feminine and masculine, that has no biological blueprint in nature. I didn't even know what to ask for. All I knew was that the discomfort with my breast had been unbearable. I wanted them gone. Medicaid paid for it. Days after the surgery, I developed complications. One day I woke up and knew something was wrong. My feet were ice cold, starting to discolor, and in a hysterical state, I went to the ER. I had developed Raynaud's syndrome. They sent me home with a Valium, which at first relaxed, then sent my body into shock, causing me to abruptly wake up with sweat pooled under my eyes. Shortly after, I developed bony prominences, heat rashes, random sharp pains, skin discoloration, and would bruise when my doctors tried to check my pulse. For months, I hardly slept, because the ringing of the tinnitus was so loud, I felt isolated and was inconsolable. It took me 2 years, but I'm the most emotionally stable I've been in my entire life. But not because of the gender-affirming care I received. High risk, invasive, has left me with a deformed body and complications I still struggle with today.
那么在这之后呢，他意识到这种所谓的治疗方式是完全错误的，因为他在切除了胸部之后，他的心理状况并没有得到任何缓解，但是他现在失去了更多，他失去了原本属于他的身体器官，而且这个东西是没有办法逆转的。在接下来这段视频呢，就是他在佛罗里达州的这个医学会议上面发表的一段演讲。
I had physical health issues that had been previously overlooked. Had that been managed, I would have never gotten the surgery. The surgery was an abhorrent misdiagnosis. The goal of healthcare should always be to get to the root cause of the problem.
Today I am more grounded than I have been in my entire life, but I am mutilated. Between my carved up body and the physical complications, I often question if there's anything on the other side. Where my breasts were are hollow. I can never get them back. I can never fit a dress the same way again. I can never breastfeed. Who will love me? You know what keeps me going? Stopping this from happening to someone else. Thank you for your time. You will have a lot to consider, and I know you will make the right decision.
他在接受这个手术的时候已经是一个30岁的成年人了。在这个年龄呢，可以说是思想逐步的愈发成熟的年龄。但是他自己当时2020年的时候，他30岁，他也相信说，哎，切除身体器官的这种方法，这种所谓的治疗手段啊，他的心理疾病就会得到治疗。那医生跟社工在这个中间起到了不可推卸的责任，因为医疗人员也肯定了这种想法，并且告诉他，他应该去做这样的手术。那医生呢，并没有按照患者应该接受的治疗方式去治疗，反而就草草的给他签了一个手术单，就去切吧，啊，反正切完了之后呢，跟这个医生也没有任何的关系，而且这个医生还可以从中间大捞一笔。